large blue was always rare and elusive and assiduously sought after by the old collector, so it was always a great find. But efforts to conserve it actually date back to the 1920s. And indeed, the National Trust has long been involved in its efforts to conserve it because we own an awful lot of its former sites. So we've been intrinsically linked with it for a long, long time.
Collard Hill is a wonderful example of limestone grassland. The steep slopes mean the soils are very thin, which means we have a lovely array of flowers here. From June to July, it's awash with purples, pinks and yellows. It's a glorious landscape, and obviously having a rare species like the large blue just brings it to life even more.
Here, they're actually quite easy to identify, although you must just stand back a bit and say it's not a large butterfly. It's actually the biggest of our blues, and our blue butterflies are really rather small. So that's its name. But the upper sides are really very glorious. It's our only butterfly with a deep royal blue. And with a black border, a thick black border along the upper side wing edges, and then on the forewing, distinct black teardrop marks. Now, no other butterfly in this country has those markings. The undersides are also quite distinctive. Most important, there's no orange on them. That separates them from the common blue and the Adonis blue. Collard Hill is supporting really quite a large population of this butterfly beyond our wildest dreams. Over 1,000 people visit to see this butterfly, which is absolutely fantastic.
It was reintroduced in Collard in the year 2000, and since then the numbers initially they grew and then they declined, and we had a bit of trouble getting the grazing exactly right. We've made some key changes to how we manage the habitat here so that we can focus the grazing on the slope. And since 2005, the numbers have built year on year.
The Large Blue Recovery Project is a huge partnership led by science, by top scientists. Without that, we would flounder. So the National Trust is just one of a group of over 20 partners. We're very, very diverse in name, but the science is absolutely core, because it's the science that pragmatises and helps deliver the conservation work.
By getting the grazing right, we're able to create the conditions where the ant can thrive, and therefore the butterfly, which has this special relationship with the ant, can also thrive. It's also got the wild thyme, which is the food plant of the large blue, so it can lay its eggs on the wild thyme, and then the caterpillars, once they hatch from those eggs and drop to the ground, can be adopted by the red ant. So it has all the qualities. It has the south-facing slopes, steep, very warm, wild thyme, and it's got the Myrmica sabellite ant in abundance.
There are good butterfly years and there are bad butterfly years, really depending on how the summer is faring. They are collectively very useful indicators to us as to how our climate is changing. They yo-yo up and down with the weather. One of our main challenges is actually ensuring that everyone who visits, and they can come from a very long way off, actually manages to see the butterfly. So what we call habitat management is crucial. Get that wrong and we lose this butterfly, and there's a lot of egg on our faces. So we've got to get that right, and we have got it right very well.